The World Gut Barging Association, Hotel Babylon, Channel 4, May 96.
Somerset, England, where top athlete Matt Maurice is up early as today's a big day in his sporting calendar. He'll be meeting his toughest ever opponent, the all-Devon champion, Chernobyl. Serious preparation starts immediately.
When there's a big competition, I always have a nice big breakfast, just to keep my weight up. And plenty of beer to bloat me out and make my stomach solid.
There's mutual respect for each other's reputation.
If I don't beat him this time, second time, he's fucking dead.
Yeah, what tactics I'll use, I'll just get all beered up and just beat him around the pub.
So what sport brings these two great champions together?
Gut barging.
Excuse me?
Gut barging.
Well, gut barger is a chap that stands on a mat and basically barges the other opponent off the mat.
Bridget's midday and Matt Maurice arrives at the arena. Loyal fans are warming up with a little pre-barge refreshment. As the contestants get smeared in engine oil and partake in some pre-bout banter, let's check out their previous form. Chernobyl, at 130 kilos, was the all-Devon champion before retiring in 1992. Tempted back to fight today after hearing Matt Maurice was looking for a challenger. Matt Maurice, at 124 kilos, is number one on the gut barging register and is unbeaten.
Guts up, gentlemen, please.
What are we doing in the face of danger?
We are!
It's 2:30 and the referees called them in. And they're off. Matt Maurice is off to a good start using his famous Johnny Turks to barge Chernobyl back. It's going to be a quick finish. But oh no, Chernobyl's fighting back using short, sharp barges for impact. Oh, what a dirty trick! Matt Maurice has gone for the Norwegian rule and given Chernobyl a bellyful. It's all over. Let's see that again.
The winner with 55 points is Madame Maurice, the Belgian from Melchum.
So Chernobyl, all Devon champion, was creamed by Matt Maurice.
Gentlemen, please.
But at least he got the booby prize.
The Devonshire Inn, a non-ranking contest, BBC West, June 1996.
It's not what you'd expect to find in your local. In one corner, the current world champion, Mad Maurice, the Belgian from Melksham. In the other, the all-Devon champion and challenger in this exhibition bout, Chernobyl, both settling in for a spot of pre-bout training.
A little bit of this, a little bit more of this, and then a little bit more of that.
British beef, got to eat plenty of British beef. That's the thing to eat, you know, because I will only ever eat anything that's crazier than me.
Gut barging is making a comeback.
There certainly are records from the 19th century, and I think it was actually a West Country landlord, Fernley Valance. He was 52 stone when he died. He was he's the WG Grace of gut barging. Fine man.
But the sport slipped into decline until the World Gut Barging Association was formed 3 years ago, introducing rules and formal bouts.
Effectively, it had gone underground. A number of people, some of my own competitors actually, have made a living barging in pubs around the country, but there was a lot of double dealing and a lot of dubious practices, a lot of injuries, and as I say, the finer moves and the finer traditions of the sport were becoming lost.
Dreaming of victory.
I don't dream, I know it's there.
Nowadays, baby oil is used. It stops the skin splitting, but ancient bravado remains. And traditional rules are adhered to.
I warn you, gentlemen, I want a good, clean bout. Guts up and barge on!
Refereed by a Baloo, each bout is the best of three rounds, with points for technique. A half blubber is a popular move.
You've got to have a gut. Because gut bulging without a gut just ain't gut bulging, you know? But as heavy as you are, you've still got to be fairly fit. You've got to be agile, you've got to be quick on your toes. I mean, there's a lot of technique to it as well. It ain't just running at each other and bouncing off.
A national championship is planned for August, with barges coming from as far afield as Germany and Australia. The sport, say the organisers, can only get bigger. And even though only reputations are at stake in this bout, it still finishes heatedly, with Mad Maurice disqualified for cheating.
The third round has been voided due to illegal contact.
The Warehouse, Norwich, Anglia TV, Barging in the Fens, June 1996.
Okay, so I know what you're thinking. How can be eating and drinking to excess in a pub be preparation for a sport? Well, I'll tell you. It's a new craze. It's called gut barging. Unfortunately, the Olympics... Gut barging, madam. Unfortunately, the Olympics wouldn't have them. I say unfortunately in the loosest possible way. But the Warehouse will. It's the British version of sumo wrestling. To find out more, please welcome ex-Norwich student Binky Braithwaite and his opponent, Mad Maurice, the Belgian. Listen, Binky, Maurice, and of course this is the referee, the Baloo, Tony. Now, listen, Binky, nice to meet you.
Hello.
You may recognise him from the Clint Eastwood film Every Which Way But Loose. Now listen, Binky, this is, can you tell us a little bit about the actual sport, gut barging?
Basically, it's a 19th century sport which fell into decline and I'm trying to revive it. And we're doing a roadshow around the country. We're trying to find that man in Norwich who will take on Mad Maurice. He's got to be out there somewhere. Somebody in East Anglia's got to have the guts to take on our man.
Right, OK. Now, the bit, you've got this Bombay Mix stuff here. What's that all about? What do you do with the Bombay Mix?
There's a serious intimidatory period before the bout, and the Bombay Mix, there's ritualistic insults. The Bombay Mix actually is borrowed fairly directly from sumo wrestling.
Right. So it's the equivalent to throwing the rice or the chalk?
Yeah, except without the religious connotations.
OK, so it's like to put the other opponent off. They go, oh, food! And how much do you actually drink to get... Because you need... It is gut barging, so you need...
You have to drink a great deal of beer, and normally, when you're in the training period, it's 4 or 5 pounds of best British beef! First thing in the morning, yay! And a pint of bull semen!
I couldn't possibly comment on that, but...
It does wonders for the gut.
So, is this not really, though, just a sport that was invented to transform fat alcoholics into a sportsman of like that?
No, you've got to understand our guys are athletes, right? This is a martial art.
OK, listen...
I don't normally do it myself. I'm just doing it for the cameras today, but... Mad Maurice has made a living out of it for the last 12 years.
OK, I'm going to interrupt you there. You're going to give us a little bit more of a demonstration and then I'm going to get a lesson,
I believe. Are we going to do it seriously now?
No, you're going to do a demonstration. But give us a little bit of the real thing. Here we go. Let's have a round of applause. Now listen, I'm trying to be one of you guys. I've got the tattoos. And... Now listen, you're going to give me a bit of a lesson. Have I got a gut big enough for this?
Yeah. Well, I think a couple of 6 months in training, but
okay.
No, you don't really. We'll give it a go.
Okay. Give me a lesson. What do I have to do?
I think take out public liability insurance.
Shit! What do I do?
Adopt the barging position. Shoulders back.
I need to get a canal if I'm going to go barging.
Listen to me, listen to me. You're under my management now, boy. Right, look at me. Shoulders back, bend the knees, gut forward.
Oh, God.
Right.
I didn't realise how much fun that was. Now, thank you very much indeed to Morris and Binky for coming along this evening. Let's hear it. OK, if you want to join in the fun and frolics in the warehouse, call us now on 0891 11 11184. That's 0891 11 11184.
Wow, National Children's TV, Fat and Slapstick, September 1996.
Yes, because actually... Girls, this is going to be pretty horrible.
It is horrible.
Yeah. They're fat, they're wobbly, they've got huge guts, and they're fighting. Have a look at them.
Oh.
Meat! Ah! Break! Ah! Guts up! Barge on!
I know. It may just look like grown, sweaty men rubbing against each other, but no, this is in fact the ancient sport of gut barging, which is grown, sweaty men rubbing against each other, basically. And to tell us all about it, will you please welcome the gut father himself? It's Binky Braithwaite. Binky, good to see you, mate.
Hello, mate.
So, we've seen a bit of an example of what's going on. What is gut barging? Is it really a proper sport?
Barge on!
It's a 200-year-old British version of sumo wrestling. It gets quite lively. Basically, the object is to barge your opponent from the mat using the stomach and no other part of the body.
And what kind of training? What kind of training do you need to become a gut barger?
Well, everybody has their own style, but essentially, you eat as much as you can, you drink as much as you can,
right.
You take no exercise. We don't do thin and we don't do stairs.
We don't. Yeah. Don't Binky, do thin.
Hello. Binky, me old mate, I've got a question for you.
Meat.
Because your referee, who's called Baloo here, like Baloo the Bear, he's wearing these like, rubber gloves, marigolds. What's all that in aid of?
Yeah, well, that's a bit strange.
Hold on!
Would you like to touch those guys with your bare hands?
Good point. Ooh. I certainly wouldn't. Also, I've noticed that. They were molesting the audience with this. This is Bombay mix from Indian restaurants. Now, what's all that for?
It's a bit like sumo. You use it to intimidate your opponent.
What, you throw it? Like...
You throw it around, not on the floor.
Oh, sorry.
But you can also eat it between the rounds. If you start to get a bit peckish,
very
you can
nice.
Have a mouthful.
I think what we have to do here is take part and a bit of gut barging.
No, Binky, not me, Sim.
No, not you.
Me.
Binky, if you'll take to the sidelines,
certainly.
I think I know the perfect person. Now, you've never met him before, but he looks after safety here at the studio. That's you, Curtis. Come on, mate.
Oh, no!
It's your turn.
This is Curtis, who works for the St. Brian's Ambulance Organisation, and he's responsible for all the health and safety in the studio.
Right,
and he's also blessed with the right frame for gut barging.
Right. I'm light on my feet. Oh, look, light on my feet.
Curtis, we think that you're the man for the job. You know, you've got this. So go for it, really.
It's all yours, Baloo.
Yeah,
it's all yours.
Take it away.
On the left, the organ donor.
Yeah!
And you are... Curtis the Barbarian.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah,
Curtis the Barbarian.
Yeah.
Oh. Go on.
Hang on a minute. Hang on. What? Just strip off.
What's the problem?
That's better.
What's the problem?
Isn't it funny how some clothes make you look fat?
Guns up!
Right.
Barge on!
That's gut barging for you. Still to come on WOW.
We've got Dial Dita Brummer on this number, 0891-111-333, 0891-111-333. Don't forget to ask permission.
Plus the Boo Radleys play on WOW.
I don't know what's going on
about after the break. Yeah, I don't know.
Ambulance!
The Richard and Judy Show, September 1996. Watch Judy, it's a peach. Very good.
Are you Binky?
I am indeed.
Yes. Binky, right. This is Binky Braithwaite. Thank you very much. You can tell us about this ancient art of gut barging, because is it medieval in origin?
There are apocryphal tales going back many, many centuries, but our own records only go back to the 19th century. Yeah. So I can't substantiate it beyond that.
So it's been in abeyance for what, the last 60, 70 years?
Fell into decline, yes. Yeah. Became a rather sordid underground event, lots of side betting and injuries. And through the formation of the World Gut Barging Association, we're trying to regulate the sport and bring it to the attention of the public.
Right, now who have we got here?
Two very fine barges. We've got the organ donor on the left, so named. He donates organs to medical research, those of his opponents.
That's organ donor, all right.
And we've got Mad Maurice, the Belgian from Melksham, who's the current world gut barging champion.
So you're from Belgium, yeah?
I am.
You're right. No, it's like, I'm not making an issue of it.
Who said Belgium didn't export impressive stuff? Right. Now, how big do the stomachs have to be a serious contender?
An average fighting gut is probably about 44, 46 inches and probably total 20 stone, I think, is... We've got guys up to 28 stone and some down to 19 and a half, probably, is about the lightest.
So that's the lightest fighting gut?
Yeah.
Do they have a weigh-in before they start?
No, I think we... We just judge them visually. There's no need to weigh them, really.
Your colleague here just said that you put straps on the guts as well.
Is that strap-on guts?
Oh, strap-on guts. Oh, I see.
We have
the sumo wrestler.
Sort of thin people.
So I could have a crack at it. But not today. Well, I'm glad I managed to stop that one. Okay, just take us through some of the finer points of the thing before we see a proper match.
Okay, we'll demonstrate two or three of the most interesting moves. The first is the full Johnny Turk, which is one explosive barge worth 15 points.
Should we stand back?
Removes the opponent from the mat. Gentlemen, the full Johnny Turk. Whoa, splendid. that was a fine example, actually.
What's the Bombay mix for?
That comes in the intimidatory period. Basically, you hurl it at your opponent, the audience, and the barman frequently.
Right.
And you can eat it between rounds if you start to feel that you're slimming down at all.
Show us another technique. We
can try the shimmy now. This is a side glancing barge, also worth 15 points. Very sophisticated. Gentlemen, the shimmy.
Wow!
this is a
glancing blow.
Mad Maurice flies off the mat like a bar of soap.
Yeah, yeah, right. And something called the Bernie Bye-Bye?
The Bernie Bye-Bye, very unusual move, especially on this small-scale mat, but basically they charge each other, miss completely, and hurtle into the audience. The only injuries normally are to the audience.
To us, yes.
That's why we're sitting this side.
Are they going to do this for us?
No, I think we better skip the Bernie Bye-Bye because we've got valuable cameras there. All right, well, we've got a contest coming up, right?
I believe we have, yes.
OK, well, do you want to...
Well, in order to have a proper contest, we need to bring in the Blue here, who's the referee.
How do you do, sir?
Quavercliff.
Hello.
Mexican and Sunderland, his parents.
Are we ready? Meet!
Steady. Frightening, you see. Often contest is won or lost at the same time.
Guts up!
Come on, Maurice.
Hold on!
Well done. We normally have three rounds.
Have another one.
Casualties.
Is he okay? The winner, Mad Maurice.
You can see why he's the world champion.
Well done,
right.
Maurice. Maurice is all right. Now it's got barges in action. New world champion Mad Maurice over there, who was challenged by the fragrantly named organ donor. And they're here to keep best of order. His expert and MC Binky Braithwaite. Thousands of people phoned in. They want to see it all again.
Oh, splendid.
You've got something. Yes. You have found something.
Come back for some more.
This was the 19th century thing. Just a quick recap. The 19th century pub sport. Genuine sport.
Yes, which we're in the process of reviving and trying to sort of authorise. Spread the word.
Yes. Beat sumo wrestling, hollow, I think.
I think we could take on the sumo guys and win. Yes, definitely.
You've got another move to show us. The half blubber.
The half blubber. Yes, this is quite an interesting move. It's a series of short, sharp jabbing barges which displaces the opponent from the mat.
Can we see that?
Gentlemen, the half blubber. not all
that effective. Go on, Morris.
He's from Belgium, isn't he?
He is from Belgium, yes.
Sure is. And I'm a monkey's uncle. All right, we're going to have another...
Really?
Who won last time? I forgot.
You've got to watch
what's the nipple ring?
Nipple ring in your necklace, because I dread to think what the consequences
horrible jewellery accidents.
Yes. All right. Now, why are you called...
Okay, well, we've got 45
seconds. You're the Balu, which is the referee. Balu.
Okay, Balu.
Are we ready?
You're ready.
Meet.
Oh, come on.
Come
on, Murray. Oh, hey, here we go for the Bob Baby. Off we go for the Bob Baby.
Come on, Baymans.
Give it, Bean Boy. Bargon. Oh, come on, go on. Oh, there it goes.
It's over there, gentlemen, over there.
Hold on!
Oh, my God!
You love it.
Blimey, is that it?
This is the other record.
Oh, he's the winner,
this
right.
guy, he's the winner. He can sink a pint in the pot.
Good man.
Well, good luck with it.
Thank you
very much indeed.
That was very nearly, very dangerous.
I think you can see that in the cobalt rooms sometime later today. Right.
Thank you, lads. That is it for today. Tomorrow you can meet the love doctor, whose theory is that men are from Mars.
I am the love doctor.
He is, yeah. Women are from Venus. You may laugh, but it's making him a millionaire. He's here with tips to make your relationship last.